Tom, halo Alkenso, halo Alkenso, bye. Hoffman, sir, hemolysis. So this session also we have discussed in the haloalkane chapter. In the very first chapter, haloalkane halogen, already we have done the Hoffman's hemolysis, where we got the amines from the haloalkanes. So haloalkanes react with the ammonia in alcoholic medium to give out an amine. And the amine so follow undergo further reaction from primary to secondary amine, then secondary to tertiary amine, then again into what to the quaternary ammonium salts. Okay, so if you take your haloalkanes related to the ammonia in place of alcohol, will get a primary amine. The primary amine on further reaction with the haloalkane will give what to the secondary amine. Secondary amine will undergo further reaction to give tertiary, and finally will get what to in a quaternary ammonium salts. Okay, let us see. If I take suppose C2H5Br, okay, ethyl bromide, what will ethyl bromide plus your HNS2 alcohol medium, okay. Will get what to C2H5NS2 primary. Okay, now this amine C2H5NS2 further it is what to C2H5Br plus HBr here, okay, HNBr. Will get what to C2H5 whole to NH. Okay, again C2H5 whole to NH plus C2H5Br C2H5 whole 3N plus HBr plus HBr. Clear? Okay, so this is your primary amine, this is your second amine, this is your tertiary amine. Okay, this is called what? Ethyl amine, diethyl amine, triethyl amine. Okay, now again if I take C2H5 whole 3 N plus C2H5Br, I will get what? C2H5 whole 4 to N plus into Br plus. This is called what? Quaternary ammonium salt. Okay, so ethyl bromide you have taken. I got here what your ethyl amine, here what your diethyl amine, here what your triethyl amine, here what your so quaternary ammonium salt. Okay, tetra ammonium bromide. Okay, zero. Quaternary ammonium salt. Okay, so haloalkanes aid the ammonia in alcoholic medium to give water primary amine. This primary amine further it with your haloalkane to give secondary amine, secondary give your tertiary, and tertiary gives what? Quaternary ammonium salt. Clear? 8. Okay. So from alcohol so by hemolysis. When alcohol so when a mixture of alcohol and ammonia are heated in place of Al2O3 alumina or thoria THO2, then your amines are formed. And once the amine formed, further add with your alcohol so to give your second amine and then tetraamine. Okay, let us see. Your C2H5OH ethyl alcohol, okay, we go for NH3 ammonia because of Al2O3 623 Kelvin. Okay, you get what your C2H5NH2 NS1. Okay, now this ammonia on further reaction with what your the alcohol. Minus water, you can water C2H5O2 NH2. Again, further, you know, C2H5O2 water, C2H5O3 N. Okay, so in this way, the alcohols are converted into amines. Okay, see alcohols will be ammonia in place of Al2O3 at 623 Kelvin to give what the primary amine. The primary amine on further with the alcohol to give what second amine, then second into the tetraamine. Clear? Okay, also if I take phenol related to your ammonia. Because of NiSO, ZnCl2 at 573 Kelvin, this what you know? NS2, aniline plus H2. Okay, this is your phenol, aniline. Okay, so what you can say, when a mixture of alcohol and ammonia are heated at 623 Kelvin in place of Al2O3, okay, alumina or your thoria, so TSO2, then corresponding amines are formed, the amine soap formed, and further is with your alcohol, give you second amine, then secondly again give you your tetraamine. Clear? Now, if I take for phenol react with your ammonia to in place of ZnCl2 and 573 Kelvin to give what you the aniline. Clear? So next method of preparation of amine is the preparation from amide by Hofmann bromide reaction. Okay, number 9 by Hofmann bromide reaction. This is the most important reaction. Okay, important. By Hofmann bromide reaction. What happens here? Here we are taking an amide. And when this amide is reacting with you, it is heated with you, bromine and KOH. Then amines are formed which are having one carbon less than the amide. Let us see. If I take CH3 C double O NH2 is what? Acetamide. Acetamide. Okay, now this acetamide will be what your Br2 bromine, okay, and KOH heater. So then this acetamide is really your bromine and KOH heated, then what we are getting? CH3NH2 plus KBr plus K2CO3 plus water, okay, 4KOH, 2KBr, okay. Now CH3CONH2 acetamide plus Br2 plus 4KOH heated giving what you CH3NH2 plus 2KBr plus K2CO3 plus 2H2. Okay? So here you see this acetamide is having two carbons, CH3, CH2. Here the amine formed is having what? Only one carbon. So amides undergo reaction with your bromine to give amine, where the amine obtained having one carbon less than the corresponding amides. Okay, so this kind of reaction is having the importance when we are going for step down conversions. Okay, so what you can say, amides with bromine and KO2 to give amines with one carbon less, this is called what? Hofmann bromide reaction. Okay, here you see when acetamide with your bromine and KO2, then we are getting an amine with one carbon less. Now these things we can apply for the conversions. Let's see if I convert ethyl alcohol to methyl alcohol. Let's see, C2H5O2, ethyl alcohol, go for oxidation, we get what? CH3COH2. Okay, now ammonia, heat, we get what? CH3CONH2. Now Br2KOH. Amine, your bromine KOH to give what? Amine with one carbon less. With one carbon less. And this so with the HONO, you want to see it. So you see, by using this Hofmann bromide reaction, so we convert this ethyl alcohol into methyl alcohol with one carbon less. Okay. Similarly, so for this reason, if I take benzamide, what do you mean? Br2 plus Br2 plus KOH. Okay. Heat, I get what? Aniline, NH2 plus K2CO3 plus 2KBr plus 2H2O, okay, 4K also, right? So, benzamide, it with your bromine and KOH, then heated, giving what? Aniline. So, in this case, also we can get your aromatic amines. Okay. This Hofmann bromide reaction is very important reaction, so because it is having many applications. So, while we are converting from one organic compound into other with your step downs. Okay. So repeat again, what is Hofmann bromide reaction? It is the reaction of acid amide with bromine and KOH to give an amine with one carbon less. Okay. Now, suppose we will have some more application of Hofmann bromide reaction. Let us see if I go for convert or acetaldehyde into formaldehyde. Okay. Acetaldehyde CH3CHO oxidation. Okay. K2CO2 plus H2O4, get what? CH3COH. Now NH3 heat, get what? CH3CONH2. We have two KH module. CH3NH2, okay. HONO, CH3OH2, double bond. Copper, 300 centigrade, CH2. Okay. So, in this way, we can convert ester aldehyde into formaldehyde by using what? Hofmann Blumenthal reaction. We can go for step down. Clear? Now, number 10. Number 10 by Grabius thalidomide synthesis is also important. See what happens here. If I take thalidomide, so this is what you know, thalidomide. Now thalidomide, when it is what you know, KH alcohol is. Here, this H will be replaced by the K, real what you know, potassium thalidomide. Now this thalidomide, when it is what you know, ethyl added, we get water. And C2H5. Now this on hydrolysis OH2. We get water. Thallic acid. We get water. Thallic acid. Plus C2H5NH2 ethylene. Okay, so then thalidomide is your alcoholic chemical, it gives you potassium thalidomide, which all necessary the haloalkyl, alkylhalide, this water N alkyl thalidomide, and this N alkyl thalidomide on hydrolysis in acidic medium gives what your thalic acid and ethylamine. So this is called what your Grabius thalidomide synthesis. Okay, repeating again, thalidomide on this with the alcoholic KO2 gives the potassium thalidomide. Potassium thalidomide so obtained on this with your alkyl iodide gives what your N alkyl thalidomide. The N alkyl thalidomide on acidic hydrolysis gives what you know, the ethyl amine with your thallic acid. This reaction is called what you know, Grabius thalidomide synthesis. In this reaction, so we cannot get the aromatic amines, simply you can get only the aliphatic amines. Clear? This is called your know, Grabius thalidomide synthesis. Number 11. By Curtius reaction. By Curtius reaction. It's also important. So here what happens? So if you take acid quad CH3 COCl plus NaNH. This is called what one? Sodium azide. Called what one? Sodium azide. So from this we will get what? CH3C11ONH3. Call your own. Acetyl azide plus NaCl. So then acetyl chloride you heat up with you sodium azide, we are getting what or acetyl azide. This acetyl azide CH3C11ONH3 on heating is what or CH3NCO. Is it called what or methyl CH3NCO? Called what or methyl isocyanate. This how methyl isocyanate formed when heat with water CO3 NCO plus H2O heat. We are getting what one? CH3 NH2 plus CO2 methyl. Okay, so this is called what you Curtius reaction. Acetyl chloride added with this sodium azide when heated give what you acetyl azide. This acetyl azide on positive gives what you methyl isocyanate MIC, and this MIC gas okay on heating with water giving what you methyl M. This is called what you Curtius reaction. So here you see this is what you acetyl chloride. Acetyl chloride hit with the sodium azide. This one acetyl azide. Acetyl azide hit with your when heated giving what? Methyl isocyanate. Again methyl isocyanate hitting with water is giving what? Methyl amine. Clear? Number 12 from chlorobenzene. Okay, so if I take chlorobenzene with ammonia in presence of CO2, okay, heated, okay. We get what you are? Na, okay, plus CO2 Cl2 plus H2O. So when chlorobenzene it is your ammonia, if you suffer CO2O, then what happens? Aniline is formed. Aniline is formed. Okay? Now see, next is your preparation of your second amine from isocyanate. So if I take suppose CH3 CH2 NC, okay, ethyl isocyanate, and this undergo reduction, you get what? Nickel, you get what? CH3 CH2 NH2 CH2.
2H2.
This is called what one?
N-methyl. N-methyl. Ethanamine. N-methyl. Ethanamine. Finally, if I take NC, phenyl isocyanate, which is one word, phenyl isocyanate plus H2 nickel. Okay, nickel what you NHCl plus NHCl. Okay, N methyl aniline. So this is a question of secondary amine. Okay, so secondary amines can be obtained from the carbyl amines. This is what you know, ethyl isocyanate or ethyl carbyl amine. So when carbyl amines undergo reduction process of nickel, then you know secondary amines are formed. Okay, so when ethyl isocyanate undergo reduction process of nickel, then N-methyl ethanamine is formed. N-methyl ethanamine is formed. Similarly, when your phenyl isocyanate undergo reduction with the nickel, then N-methyl aniline is obtained. These are the secondary amines. Clear? So these are the methods of preparation of amines at all. This is the summary of methods of preparation of amines. You see, you can obtain ethyl amine from all these reactions. Let us see one by one. This one, you know, nitroethane undergo reduction with nickel or platinum to give ethyl amine. Similarly, methyl cyanide undergo reduction with sodium alcohol to give what? Ethyl amine. Acetamide, this is what you know, acetamide undergo reduction with lithium aluminum hydride to give what? Ethyl amine. This is what you know, methyl cyanide, this is what you know, nitroethane. Okay, now similarly, number 4, you know, propanamide, Ca3, Ca2, Cn, propanamide, and you know, bromine and KOH to give what you know, ethyl amine. Okay, this is your hope one bromidation, so amine obtained with one carbon less. So now your acetic acid, undergo first it will ammonia to form imine, and imine on reaction with what you ethyl amine. Now you know oxygen it will undergo reaction with lithium aluminum hydride to give what you ethyl amine. Now you know C3C2Br halo alkane ethyl bromide it will ammonia Fe70 Kelvin to give what you ethyl amine. Similarly, you know C3C2C propanoic acid. Propanoic acid, if you know hydrogenic acid and sulfuric acid, then you know Schemann reaction to give what to amine with one carbon less. Okay, similarly, number 9, ethyl alcohol undergo hemolysis in terms of Al2C20 Kelvin to give what to ethyl amine. Similarly, you know thalamide, third you know K1 to give potassium thalamide, then with the alkyl iodide to give what to N alkyl thalamide, then undergo respiration with your acidic hydrolysis to give what to ethyl amine. Okay, so these are the all the reactions where we are getting the ethyl amines. Okay, now this come to your aniline part. So aniline we are getting from nitrobenzene by reduction aniline, reduction gives you aniline. Now benzamide undergo hope form bromidation, so Br2KH to give what to aniline. Now benzoic acid, it with your hydrogen acid with heterosport to give what to aniline. okay, then your phenol will become ammonia in ZnCl2 at 570 Kelvin to give water aniline. So these are the different methods of preparation of aniline, and these are the methods of preparation of ethylamine. So with this all knowledge, with this knowledge, we'll try to solve more and more questions regarding conversion and identification basing on these reactions. Okay, that we'll discuss in the next class. Thank you.